It's all systems go for the much-awaited reunion concert of legendary rock band Eraserheads. Mario Dumao's exclusive report reveals the plans for the mega production, which will also showcase the music of the late Pinoy rap icon Francis Magalona.
At the first exclusive look at preparations for the much-anticipated reunion concert of the Eraserheads in Quezon City, Eli Buendia, Raymond Marasigan, Marcus Adoro, and Buddy Zabala bonded together to recreate their music. The Fab Four have all moved on from their checkered past to make possible what was once considered an unprecedented undertaking in the annals of OPM live concerts.
Just like a family, they've reconciled their differences and now they are working harmoniously. And the first night I got them together for dinner, it was like nothing has happened. Like, hey, you know. So it was really a good reunion for them. And I was so happy to see them like pick up the pieces.
The group is also brimming with ideas on how to enhance the show on December 22nd at the SMDC Festival Grounds, Parañaque City. That can accommodate an estimated 50,000 fans.
I guess because of the long break, you know, all their creative juice are pouring in. This is a show that everybody will talk about and pass on to the next generation because, wow, this thing happened.
One of the most exciting revelations is the planned guesting of OPM icon Francis Magalona through the magic of technology. Magalona was known as a good friend and creative collaborator of the E-Heads before he passed on due to leukemia in 2009.
I always get goosebumps or sometimes teary-eyed when I talk about this. As we all know, Francis M. is the fifth Eraserheads, right? And he was supposed to perform with them 13 years ago, but a few days before the concert, he passed away. And because of technology, we are going to bring him back to perform with Eraserhead through the technology of hologram.
Wow.
So, and that is just the first number.
More than the issue of supposed expensive ticket prices, the production team prefers to dwell on the meaning and relevance of the reunion show to the Filipino music industry.
They want to give the fans the best show money can buy. And the second set, some of the songs will be backed up by an 18-piece orchestra. My God, you know, so this is a show you don't want to miss. We are a proud Filipino talent, and we should be proud ourselves. And this is to showcase to the world that, hey, we can do it. We are a world-class artist, you know. So this is the statement that we want to say in this concert.
Proceeds of the Eraserheads reunion show will support advocacies for the upliftment of marginalized women and children. Mario Dumawal, ABS-CBN News.
Switching gears now, comics fans had a field day at the 2022 New York Comic Con. Don Tagala gives us the highlights of the jam-packed event.
Disney princesses, superheroes, villains, and countless comic characters came alive at the recently held 2022 New York Comic Con, an annual convention dedicated to the nerd culture and people who like to dress up as comic book characters.
Comic-Con honestly is it's just a free-for-all. There's all kinds of media, all kinds of different things happening. A lot of the studios showcase their new movies, new shows. There's also all kinds of art, books, pretty much anything media, art, entertainment. It's not just comics.
An estimated 200,000 fans came to this geek pop culture event, and films were among them.
It definitely feels normal. It feels like everything's back to normal. While it's mildly concerning, I know a lot of people are vaccinated and boosted, like myself. So it's just good to have it come back in full force.
For cosplayers like Rafael Magalong, Comic-Con is like Halloween on steroids.
I was really big into all the Marvel movies, so I definitely wanted to do Captain America after Endgame happened. For cosplaying, it's definitely just an expression of myself. Like, sure, I take Captain America, but I put my own twist on it. As you can tell, it's not just a standard Captain America, it's my Captain America. So now this is my own take on the character.
The artist alley is a dream come true for fans who want to meet the artist behind their favorite comic characters.
It's $20 for
memories will be priceless.
Absolutely.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
For others, Comic-Con is a shopper's paradise when it comes to toys and merchandise.
We got a free comic book here, and we got a number of t-shirts, but the thing, before I show them to you, this is the thing that we always go to Marvel for, is the pin pack. So you don't know which one you're gonna get, and they're kind of pricey, so I'm hoping we get something, a character that I actually like. And then we usually line them up on the lanyards. This is a new lanyard, my other one is full.
Organizers are hoping to attract more fans to Comic-Con next year. In New York alone, it has generated more than $100 million in economic activities in pre-pandemic times. Don Tagala, ABS-CBN News, New York.